insulted my grandfather, meaning the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And anyone who does so shall be killed and deserves to be killed. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, anyone who slanders Aisha after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared her innocent, فَقَدْ مَرَقَ مِنَ الدِّينِ, then he exits the fold of Islam, as in his book As-Sarim al-Maslul, page 568. وَقَالَ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ, anyone who slanders her is belying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that which he informed about her innocence. And anyone who belies Allah then commits kufr. And that it is not sufficient that he be whipped because he belied 17 verses in the book of Allah, as we mentioned in part 1 that came in Surah An-Nur. Al-Karki, Al-Majlisi, from the infamous of the rejectionists. They curse Abu Bakr, they curse Umar, they curse Uthman, they curse Muawiyah, they curse Aisha, and they curse Hafsa, and Hind, and Umm al-Hakam, the sister of Muawiyah. In fact, they say, and that our creed, quote, is to be innocent from the idols, the four idols, Abi Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Muawiyah, from the men, and from women, the four women, Aisha, Hafsa, Hind, Umm al-Hakam, and from all of their followers, and that they are the evil of creation on the face of the earth. This is related by Ibn Babawayh al-Qummi, and he related the consensus of the rejectionists on this. And the one who is called As-Saduq from them, he said, وَنَعْتَقِدُ فِيهِمْ أَنَّهُمْ أَعْدَاءُ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولُهُ. And that we believe that they are the enemies of Allah and His Messenger, and that no one's belief will be completed, no one's belief will be completed, meaning no one's belief in Allah and His Messenger and the Imams, quote unquote, except after declaring oneself innocent and disassociated from their enemies. And who are the enemies? Those we mentioned earlier. This is in the book by Al-Hidayah للصدوق, Qaf 110, and وحق اليقين by Al-Majlisi, page 519. So they curse Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Muawiyah, may Allah be pleased with all of them, and disassociate themselves from them. And they curse the daughter of Abu Bakr, Aisha, and the daughter of Umar, Hafsa, and declare themselves innocent from them, and they claim that they and their followers, meaning Ahlul Sunnah, are the worst evil on the face of the earth. Everyone knows that Abu Bakr wa Umar wa Uthman is the best, and that the daughter of Abi Bakr, and Umar, and Aisha, from the best. The rejectionist. Also claim that Aisha and Hafsa, may Allah be pleased with them, poisoned the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that they conspired with their fathers and made him drink the poison, and that this was the cause of his death alayhi salatu wasalam, according to their lines. And they take as evidence, look what they take as evidence, they take the Quran as evidence. Let us see. They take Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse 114 to conclude this. وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل أفإن مات أو قتلا قلبتم على أعقابكم. They believe in Allah and the last day, then enjoin al-ma'ruf and forbid the munkar. Maybe this is incorrect, the quotation.
بسم الله الرحمن.
It should be 144 please. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is no more than a messenger, and indeed many messengers have passed away before him. If he dies or is killed, will you then turn back on your heels as disbelievers? One of the rejectionists, Al-Ayashi, he said, do you know what this verse means? It means that he was poisoned before he died. They, meaning referring to Aisha and Hafsa, they were the ones who gave him the poison. Al-Kashani added to this in his book Tafsir al-Safi volume 1, 305, يعني المرأتين, and then he cursed them. والعياذ بالله. This means the two women, and he cursed them, and he cursed their father. And we said, he said, that they and their fathers are the worst of creation. This is in this Ayashi's Tafsir, volume 1, page 200, and As-Safi Lil-Kashani, volume 1, page 305, and Bihar al-Anwar Lil-Majlisi, volume 6, page 504. Many of their authors related this story, and they named Aisha and Hafsa and their fathers explicitly, and that they were the ones who put the poison to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he died as a result. In Tafsir al-Qummi, إن الصراط المستقيم للبياضي، إن شرح نهج البلاغة لابن أبي الحديد، إن إحقاق الحق للتستري، أن ماني A fabricated story. Against whom? Against the ones whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam testified for them to be from the people of paradise. And he died while pleased with them. And the Sahabi al-Jaleel Ammar bin Yasir. May Allah be pleased with him and his father. And Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali bin Abi Talib. May Allah be pleased with him. And Ammar bin Yasir, may Allah be pleased with him. Swear that Aisha Umm al-Mu'mineen is the wife of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this life and in the hereafter. Aisha and Hafsa, from the most beloved of the wives of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and their fathers from the most beloved of men. And the one who points in the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is Al-Labid bin Asam, Al-Yahudi, the Jew. You can tell, even there are matters which I did not discuss concerning their slanders, but sufficient is what has been mentioned. And if it tells anything, it tells that even the hatred of these rejectionists far exceeds those who ascribe not to Islam from the Kafirs. Last point. We know that Aisha and Khadija are from the mothers of the believers. May Allah be pleased with them all. As to who is more meritorious, Aisha or Khadija, the people of knowledge differed. Some said that Aisha, some said Khadija, and the correct position is to say that their rank with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not for us. This is to Allah alone. As to the preference between them in regard to that which appears to us from their actions and their situations in this life, then this is a matter apparent, known. As to them being wives of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام.